Hello, and welcome to the Colonial TV 2020 Holiday Show. I'm Caleb Supernor.
And I'm Mikey Hayden. While we still have the current ongoing pandemic, we at Colonial TV are super excited to have you with us tonight.
That's right, Mikey. While 2020 has had its share of ups and downs, at least we can have this time to relax and enjoy the holidays.
Tonight, we'll be looking at pieces from our fellow students here in the studio. We've got some great pieces from holiday baking to a holiday dance sing-along.
Let's get started with the first piece we have tonight from Theodore Ciacarone, who took on the classic How the Grinch Stole Christmas, but this Grinch has taken over SHS. Now, Mikey, you were a big part of this piece. Can you give us any insight on the piece?
Let's just say I made green look good. Now let's take a look.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole. Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole. You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch. You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile, Mr. Grinch. Given the choice between the two of you, I'd take the seasick crocodile.
Wow, what a fun take on the classic story by Dr. Seuss. And you do make green look good.
Of course I do, Caleb. You know what else the Grinch likes to do?
Eat.
Such as my favorite, gingerbread cookies.
Now you're making me hungry for gingerbread, which is what Paris Agiomavridis showcased in her holiday baking show. Gingerbread can be hard to make if you've never done it before, so make sure you at home pay real close attention if you're planning on making some this year. Let's check out how to make the perfect cookie.
Happy holidays, SHS. I hope everyone's having an amazing winter break so far. Since it's the holidays, I'm going to be showing you a really hot, festive recipe about gingerbread men. Everyone loves gingerbread men, so it's an amazing recipe to be done. Though it can be like kind of a hard recipe, so I'll do it step by step with you. The first thing you're going to want to do is measure out your wet ingredients. Pretty easy step. And now from here, you're going to want to grab a separate bowl, probably more like a large one because you're going to be mixing your dry ingredients, so it might get everywhere, so a nice large bowl. Once you have all your dry ingredients, you're going to want to move back over to your mixer. And from here, you want to add slowly your dry ingredients to your wet ingredients. So from here, you're going to want to grab some flour. And because this dough is still cold, it's not as sticky as it normally would be. But normally, it would be very sticky. So you're going to want to grab some flour and just spread some around on the table. Make it so it's nice and not so this dough doesn't stick to it. And from here, you're going to want to slowly flatten it out. I'm going to try to find my rolling pin that I did grab beforehand, right here. And I'm going to cover that in some flour as well.
Who doesn't love some holiday treats?
With the ongoing pandemic, many businesses, and especially small businesses, are suffering due to the drop in sales. Holly Riscosi produced her piece all about how you can help out your local businesses this year. Without further ado, here's Holly Riscosi reporting from White Cottage in Northborough.
With the busy holiday season upon us, it's time to get your shopping done. There are many businesses ready to go to help you in your shopping, decorating, planning, and more. Today, I have a small business spotlight on White Cottage in Northborough.
Hi, I'm Alicia Garbarino.
And I'm Cheryl Meyer, and we started White Cottage in 2013.
In 2013, Alicia Garbarino and Cheryl Meyer started what is now White Cottage from their dining room tables. The business began as design-focused, with custom window treatments and upholstery. Soon, Alicia and Cheryl were able to expand their business into consulting. By 2017, they had opened their first storefront. Here, they began growing their brand by incorporating home decor pieces and more. Cheryl Meyer, co-owner, talks more about White Cottage today.
That evolved into home decor, gift boxes, custom pillows, gift sets. We take pride in really trying to simplify the shopping experience and the design experience for all our customers.
Their gift boxes in particular have really taken off this year. By combining locally sourced items, they are able to curate an individualized and unique box for all kinds of customers, from local shoppers to corporate orders across the country. Beyond the holiday season, White Cottage's Lola pendants are a top seller, and 50% of their business continues to be their custom window treatments and upholstery. Their family and loyal customers have been with them since these beginning days, even since they've expanded to so much more. White Cottage is not only a small business within itself, but it also sources from local places as well, from their gorgeous signs and panels from rustic Marlin in Hanover, Mass., to their classic Farm and Sea candles sourced from Amesbury, Mass. These special items make the White Cottage experience unique and individualized, a common theme in small businesses. Alicia Garbarino, co-owner, discusses the importance of supporting small businesses.
The importance of supporting small businesses is the sense of community that I think we bring, not just us, but every small grocery store, hairdresser, boutique, coffee shop.
So how can you get into contact with White Cottage? Their shop is located at 290 West Main Street, Suite 2 in Northborough, Mass. Their hours are Sunday and Monday, 11 to 4 p.m., Tuesday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., Wednesday, 10 to 6, Thursday, 10 to 7, and Friday through Saturday, 10 to 5. They will be open in the week leading up to Christmas, including on Christmas Eve. They also have curbside pickup available. Finally, they are very accessible online. Their email, Facebook, and Instagram, as well as their website, are displayed, and these are all great ways to get in touch or place an order. When doing your holiday shopping this year, why not consider a local business such as White Cottage? Even after the holidays, think about supporting the local businesses in our community. This has been Holly Riscosi reporting. Back to you in the studio.
Well, I know where I'm shopping this year.
Me too. I'll have to put White Cottage down on my list of holiday errands. Next, we have an interview-style piece produced by you, Caleb. Can you tell us a little bit about what your group did for this project?
Yeah, so me and my group went around the school asking some man-on-the-street kind of questions. We wanted to get them in a bright and cheery holiday mood.
Sounds like you guys had a lot of fun with this. Let's check it out.
Ellie, what is your favorite holiday movie?
I like watching any of the Home Alone series, like 1, 2, or 3.
Yeah, those are pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
My favorite holiday movie would probably have to be National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation with Chevy Chase. What about, what's your favorite holiday movie?
The Grinch. Christmas Vacation.
You prefer Christmas Eve or Christmas Day?
Eve.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Okay. And what? Alright, would you rather spend the holidays with your family or your favorite celebrity?
Oh, my family.
Alright, and. Alrighty, would you rather have a white Christmas or just like a warm, sunny Christmas?
When I was younger, I would have rather had a white Christmas.
Yeah.
But as I've gotten older, I've tended to prefer the warmer New England Christmases.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, it definitely seems like everyone's going to have some fun and exciting times in the coming week.
Speaking of fun, our final piece tonight was produced by Caitlin Butler, who made a super fun dance dub to get everyone in the mood for some holiday cheer. Let's check it out.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive a king. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing.
Hold on. Can we switch the language?
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad.
I'm on the drum, yeah, I'm on the snare drum. Yeah, I'm on the beat cause the beat goes dumb. And I only spit heat cause I'm playing for the sun. Playing for the king, playing for the title. I'm surprised.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. Don't care.
Jingle bell,
run, Rudolph. Randolph ain't too far behind.
So much Hanukkah to celebrate Hanukkah.
Grandma got run over by a reindeer walking home from our house Christmas Eve.
The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can see every couple tries to stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring. Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll do some caroling. You will get a sentimental feeling when you hear.
That sure does get me in the mood for some dancing.
Me too. Well, that's all the time we have for you tonight on behalf of the Colonial TV studio. Thank you and happy holidays.